All right, everyone. Michael Zupan with Bite-Sized Impressions, and it's a little more Bloodborne up your ass. Yeah. I'm not really far in this game. I beat the first boss, but, you know, I've just been kind of grinding a little bit in the early game since I'm not really particularly good at these games. I don't know if I'd even use the word competent. But I think Bloodborne might actually help me be a better player for the From Software games. Because honestly, while I have not really been all that good with the Dark Souls games, even though I've always done my best, I've always gotten tens of hours worth of enjoyment out of these games, so. The next place I really have to hit. Oh, look at those. How much do I need to be able to level up? Probably not that much more, huh?
Very well. Let me.
Yeah. Let's see. I'm only a few hundred away from a level up here. I want to get my skill up. Endurance should go up too, but skill is my primary. It's my primary mode of attack. But as you can see with this, I can get in quite a few attacks with the whip. So I don't know, my endurance might be up enough for now. But let's go collect a few hundred more blood echoes there, and we'll see. We will see from there. Let me just Skype someone real quick here. By the way, Gabriel Galliani, the guy who is usually on the podcast with me, he's playing The Order 1886 right now. And I'm going to be really interested in talking to him about how he feels about it after he's completed. Bastard. Oh, he got me. Screw you. Bastard. I'm gonna get you with the cane. Screw the whip. For some reason, I hardly ever see these specters. Oh, he went for it. He didn't position that quite well, did he? He got his ass handed to him, that guy. Well, I'm pretty sure that's enough. I'll go back and level up real quick. So, things about this game. Obviously, the one thing that's very difficult to stay away from is making comparisons between this game and the Dark Souls game. Games. Demon's Souls, Dark Souls, Dark Souls 2, you know what I mean. And I don't know. There's something about Bloodborne that I'm playing this and I'm like, this is the game I kind of wished Dark Souls 2 had been.
Very well. Let me.
I mean, I still thought Dark Souls 2 was one of the more notable I thought it was one of the more notable entries for gaming in 2014, but at the same time, that doesn't really say all that much, does it? It just doesn't. I mean, 2014, there were a lot of fun games, but it wasn't one of the more memorable years in gaming for me, other than the fact that it was the first year that the PS4 and the Xbox One really, you know, got to show us, you know, their stuff. Now, fortify weapon, what do I need? Oh, I have a saw spear. I have 4 bloodstone shards so far. So I would need 4 more if I wanted to farm them out, and then 300 blood echoes in order to upgrade my threaded cane to +3. I kind of want to do that, just because I think I'm going to stick with the cane. But first, out of curiosity, let's take a look at this saw spear. What do we got? Alright, so the saw spear, it's kind of like it's like a saw almost, and then I'm assuming it just kerchink. Ooh, I don't wanna accidentally attack her. I don't know. I'm gonna go back to the cane. The cane has just so much versatility. It's like, bap, I'm gonna beat you in your frickin' head, and then, rah, chain. Alright, let's get back into Central Yharnam and do a bit more, ghoul bashing, shall we? The next part of the game that I really need to actually hit is probably the sewers and get there. So, you know what? I might attack everybody here in this Central Yharnam and then make my way over to the sewer, since I'd end up over there eventually anyway. But I do want to collect some blood echoes. I do like leveling up and whatnot. And if I could get some other things that I need to be able to fortify my weapon, that'd be great. The thing about the cane is that it really doesn't have a lot of reach, but the whip sure as hell does. And while the whip aspect of it isn't that strong, you know, what difference does it make if you have to whack someone a few more times? If it gives you the ability for some pretty decent crowd control and puts a little distance between you And your foes. One thing I really need to get used to in this game, too, by the way. Oh, we got a little mob down here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to run up behind the first guy. I'm going to hit him with my cane. I'm going to switch to the whip, and then I'm going to just swing like a freaking madman, because that's what I'm going to do, yo. Alright, switch to whip. How effective was that? Oh, where are you guys going? I'm too fast for you, huh? Damn right. Alright, so as I was saying before, it's hard, obviously, not to compare this game to the other Souls games, but in some ways, you could argue that maybe it's a bit more accessible to people. Because a couple of the things that are different is that, unlike Dark Souls 2, it kind of goes back to the original Souls style of enemy respawn. Enemies are going to just respawn in any part of the game infinitely, meaning you don't have to worry about... God damn, I always forget about that guy. And that's another thing. You just noticed probably every time that I countered him after he hit me, I had a bit of a glow around me, and I gained a little bit of health back. But there's no shield. I have a pistol in my hand. So what they want you to do is they want you to be more aggressive with these enemies. Ooh. That screwed me right there. Because if you switch to your whip, you can hit it against things. And the same is true, from what I understand, for other weapons as well. So it's not like just a downside for the whip, but... Oh, that guy's got a gun! Shots fired! Eat it, eat it, eat it. That's the thing that sucks about being down here. Ow. Ooh, he's got something for me. That was a tad bit risky. There's a guy down here I gotta take care of. Eat my shit. I want to kite these guys back away from the people with guns. Oh, thank you for falling into my little kite trap, guys. That was great, really. And again, being able to view the specter here does not work for me. I don't know, some of that online functionality does not work all that well for me, but I can always see the notes just fine. I don't know what's up with that. You will not shoot me again. Oh, there's a goddamn dog. Who let the goddamn dog loose, him? Here, Poochie. Come on out. Alright. Or just, you know, become easy pickings. That works for me, too. No problem. The first time I came to this door and I got to the end of this street, it took me a while to do, too. Oh, that's a pretty awesome view. I'm gonna screenshot that. Bam!
I heard this thing smashing on the door, and I was like, that's gonna suck. A lot. Ooh. There's something here, too. Quicksilver bullets. Use a blood vial. Make sure I have full health. Blood vials. I know the vials that you use for health back in Dark Souls. You only had so many that you could use until you reached a bonfire. That's not true here.
I don't reckon you're for 12 pounds.
I'm gonna knock on your door again, lady. What do you think about that?
I don't reckon you're
for 12. Alright. She got nothing for me. But I will beat this big ass mofo down here with a frickin' cane. Come get some, Tiny. Now that's a parry and riposte. I hadn't really done that successfully before, but basically, it's even with a big guy like him, I guess. I don't know if it's gonna work on a boss, probably not. But basically, when they're in mid animation, the swing, you shoot him with your weapon, and then you get right up in there, and then you strike him. And that seemed to make all the difference. Oh, I want the whip for this. Get down here, dude. Whatever. You can stay there. That's cool, too. I don't care. It's your funeral, pal. You, too. Come get some. Oh, I turned around and the dog bit my ass. God damn it! I'm gonna roll off to the side so he can't hit me, and now boom. Smile, you're dead. Give me some of my Quicksilver bullets back. Got almost 2,000 blood echoes here. By the way, if this is your first time watching one of my Bloodborne streams, and if you're used to playing the Souls games, one thing that you're going to notice is immediately is that when you die, you don't leave an orb on the ground that you physically pick back up in order to get those blood echoes. My god, I didn't realize he was right there. I thought he was on the other side of the bridge. Oh my god. I gotta switch back to the cane. Come at me again, dude. What the hell? I thought I was gonna stun him with the pistol. Well, that ought to teach you a big lug nut. God damn. I expected him to be way over there, and I got down to the bottom of the ladder, and he scared the piss out of me. I do not advise going that route. Yeah, you're all bite. The crows are a pain in the ass if you let them get right on top of you. But this whip is a great way to keep distance between you and these things. Oh, I know where this is going to bring me. I don't want to go down this way. Coming down here, there's guys with guns lining the side of that thing, and I don't want to risk getting shot down from the ladder. So I'm going to go back another way. One of the things that's also worth noting about your progress in this game is shortcuts. It seems like this whole Central Yharnam place that I'm in right now, it's got one bonfire, pretty much, one lantern, I guess you would call it in this game. And then after you beat the first boss, there's another one, but it's kind of a dead end. So it's really only there to save your progress when you beat the boss. It's not really doing anything else for you. Oh, I see you. Eat it. I saw you start to fly. Just stay down, please. Wonder if I can drop down there. Nope. There is a shortcut right over here, though. Oh, shiz. I'll go down there and take care of him, sure. Well, bang, you're dead. Come on up. Ooh, he avoided it. Good for him. Too bad your friends aren't as lucky. There's another one. Here, Poochie. I like animals, but I don't feel bad downing those dudes. Good, I'm back to cane mode. When I first started, I kind of forgot that I could just roll into everything. This game is really bloody, and I frickin' like that. Snuck up on him. Used my strong attack in his back, which left him wide open. For a deathly blow. Now, the ladder that I was going to climb down originally is on my right, coming out this door. And as you'll see, a couple of riflemen right there. Now, there's going to be some beastly dude chasing after me. So I'm gonna wait right here for him. Now I'm gonna pop my neck out and he's gonna scare the hell out of me. Here he comes. Run, 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 run. Beware of ambush. I'm going to rate this. Those bullets, based on the sound, almost sound like they explode on impact. I know that's not really the case, but I'll be damned if it doesn't make me think twice. Oh, this dude dropped something on the bridge before too, didn't he? Some crows up here on the walk. There's also one hiding behind those barrels up there. And since I have over 3,000 blood echoes right now, I'm probably gonna go cash those chips in. Trying to get another point in skill. Although, I could just show you how this all connects. So coming down this way, from here, you know, you kind of just feel like, hey, I just conquered that area up there. It's really tricky the first few times. It's because you kind of have to know. Oh, that dude got stuck in the wall. Anyway. So you kind of feel like, okay. I conquered that area, but I'm kind of far away from my lantern, which will help me save my progress. You could go down there. There's some pretty feisty shit down there. And down that way too. And this is the ladder that I was going to climb down from that bridge up there before. But didn't want to because I was afraid those dudes were going to shoot me down from over there. And in classic Soul fashion, the enemies that you defeat stay dead until the next time you hit the lantern. So this is sort of the shortcut back. Nope. Now I'm getting lost. It'll only be for a moment. Oh, I forgot about these guys. Shit. Whoa. I was never great at doing a parry attack. Well, a parry. In the Dark Souls games. I could just not get the timing of my my swing down. Oh shit. Hi. I know I'm almost to the lantern now, though. It's right up here. Bam. So you go back to the Hunter's Dream. That's sort of your hub. That's where you can level up, upgrade your... fortify your weapons, I should say. You can buy stuff.
Welcome, Odin. Very well, let me...
Well, the important thing with vitality is, yeah, it's nice, but I'd rather play the game like don't get hit. I mean, I think skill soft caps at like 25. If I can get that up there, I can work on all the other shit. No problem.
Farewell, good hunter.
Oh, did I get any Bloodstone Shards last time? I had 4, right? So I need 3 more. So I guess I got 1 on my run. Guess you really do gotta farm for those a bit, don't you? Well, now that I've depleted my Blood Echoes, let's make our ways straight to the sewer. And see what awaits. I'm now going to be wandering into some unknown territory here, so this could be kind of intense for me. There was this one person I had to get rid of off my friends list. They were very short-lived. There's this fan website for a band that I'm a mod at. Admin, whatever. So we played GTA Online with this kid. And he, it was so strange. Because the first thing that pops out of his mouth is like, yeah, hold on, let me get my cousin so he can play with us. I said, okay. So as soon as the other guy gets on there, he's like, you told him I'm your cousin? Listen, he's not my cousin. We're friends, and he kind of wants to bang my sister. And I'm like, is this for real? Like, it's like one of those guys that's just, he's like nice enough, and he's innocent, he's harmless, but like, he's like a perpetual liar type, and I really don't have any time or patience for anyone like that. Ow. Gained my health back. Don't bark at me. That's what you get. Yeah, so, I don't know. I tried talking to him a little bit, and I was like, tell me the truth. Are you just kind of, like, trolling a lot of the time, or are you for real? And he's like, occasionally I troll, but no. Turns out he really is just a perpetual liar. Which I have no tolerance for whatsoever. But I had him on my friends list, and I was just like, I'll keep him on my friends list, and I'll just warn him. But, like, he kept joining a party, like, every 2 minutes. I don't know why. So I kept getting that pop-up notification in the corner of the screen. And then he just kept inviting me to parties, and I'm like, I don't need to... That sucks. I try to, I just got a Bloodstone Shard for that, too. If I got a couple more, maybe farming down here is where I got it. I think I started this thought before, but forgot to finish it. In the Dark Souls games, you have those vials that you get for health, and you only have so many. And they're all that you can use until you reach the next bonfire. In Bloodborne, it's really different. Enemies actually drop blood vials, which sort of do the same thing. They restore some health. Whoa, that dude meant business. Come get me, bro. Why is he not coming? Well, that does it for him. Right off the ledge. I knew I had the roll because that dude was there on the bridge. Ooh. Did 2 inches of water save me? Since I'm going to be going down instead of up here, which I have not yet done, I wanted to make sure I had full health there, so. There's quite a few of these guys in the water, isn't there? Is there another one? There sure is. There's one here, too. Boy, they just lay in wait like they're dead, man. Surprise. It's a good thing when I see something questionable, I hit down on the R3 stick. See, there's one there too. Ow. Any more? Yeah, when you hit down on the R3 stick, what happens is you, I hear something growling back there. It basically, toggles onto an enemy. More of them. Back up. I saw that dude reaching. What the fuck? Oh, is that a crow? Fuck you. They sound really scary when you're not expecting them. They've got a really beastly sound. I would not want to get stuck in here trying to fight anything. Ow. What the hell? More crows scare the shit out of me. What in the hell? You're just done, dude. What the fuck? Big frickin' pig or something, what the shit? I got a couple of different options here, and I don't know which way I want to go. Well, that's not where the ladder is. It's the next one down, isn't it? I guess I'll go up here. That's a pretty big ladder. Oh, okay. I know where this is. I beat these two guys before you saw me do it. It's back closer to the bonfire. So this is actually really good, because this gives me just yet another shortcut to get down to the sewers. Fuck you, dude. Unlock. I'm gonna get a little bit further away so they sort of reset. So they're not both on my ass. Yeah, see? Now I can string this guy away a little bit. Oh, that's the only way to face these guys. That's awesome. I rip out your belly, bitch. I might as well just see who else there is to kill real quick. I've almost got enough souls to level up, and I unlocked a shortcut. Which is awesome. Oh, you know what? I didn't kill this guy in here. You just see this dude sitting here in this wheelchair, right? And you approach him, you think he might be like one of those friendly NPCs, and you get in front of him and he's like, "Busybody! Busybody!" He's like, "Nope, I've got a hand cannon." Let's see, beware of ambush. Fine. That's a good note. You hear all these noises of people talking too, that's creepy. The game is genuinely creepy, much more so I think than Dark Souls was. And the horror setting has a lot to do with it. This dude is hard to see unless you know he's there. Things suck. Yeah, come get it. Actually, ow. Even in the door, I get fucked with. Back doggy. I feel like a lion tamer with the whip. Well, with that in hand, let's level up again, because why not? Very content with unlocking that shortcut. Somebody pointed out on Gaff today that this Bloodborne splash is off center, but it's really only because the bee in Bloodborne has that little tail hanging off to the left of it.
What is it you? Very well, let me stand close.
Yeah.
Farewell, good hunter.
Whip mode. Pimp cane. Alright, let's see what I got here in my inventory. I'm looking at... blah, blah, blah. There's 6 bloodstone shards now, and I could have 8. Because I would like to upgrade my cane to a +3 if I could, because why not? I mean, I haven't faced the second boss yet. I always look here after doing some stuff if I can get in this action here. Nope. And actually, after beating the first boss, I wonder if there's any new items for me to buy down here at this little ghoul well. Oh, blood vial, quicksilver bullets. By the way, pebbles, you saw me pick those up before. You can just toss them, basically, to gain the enemy, the attention of an enemy. Draw them to you, perhaps separate some foes from their pack that they're with, too. Key to the gate to the Grand Cathedral's Round Plaza? I somehow think you have to be able to find that on your own. Oh, I now have access to be able to buy other starter weapons. Ooh, the Kirk Hammer is here, but I've been investing everything in skill, and this is primarily a... strength, and it requires 16 in strength, which I would need to work a bit on. The hunter axe, though. Saw spear I found on my own. Saw cleaver, it's more strength. This is more for skill. I kind of want to buy the blunderbuss, though. It's kind of like, right now, the hunter pistol, it has better range. The blunderbuss is definitely more for short range. But... well... I don't really need any of this stuff. Some new attire would be nice, but that's not happening right now either. Well, every time I'm here, I like to just repair my weapon, because why the hell not? I kind of want to make my way to the sewers like I did before instead of taking that new shortcut, though, because if I find that one of those enemies in that room will actually drop a bloodstone thing for me, that's actually pretty optimal. So I could farm a couple more of those right in that area if that's where I get them from. It could be completely random in this entire central Yharnam area either. I mean, it could be. So, who knows? That would probably make the most sense. I think they really want you to farm for those instead of not be like, oh, this is where I can find them again. Because then the game would just be stupid easy. Because then you could just level up as much as you fortify your weapons as much as you want, basically. But I don't know. Maybe that's the intent. Maybe they want you to have different weapons for different situations. And they want you to find enough of those things so that you can upgrade all your weapons as much as you want. I don't know.
Go!
just hit him with one hit. Was taking me too. Maybe that last upgrade in skill really did a lot of awesome good there. Oh, well, I did hit him with the pistol. I wonder if you get far away enough from the cages going down this way with your back to them, if they somehow come out of their cages. I don't know. I've never tested my luck, because that's what gets you killed in this game. And I'm not about testing my luck, that's for sure. I like to kill this guy, because once he sees me on the bridge, he'll come after me. And I know a lot of people, oh, well, you can just run through parts of the game, and I don't know, I don't like doing that. I like to obliterate everything in my path. It feels more careful, it feels safer. It nets me more blood echoes, which are the souls in this series of games. Usually I think it was taking me 5 hits to kill this guy. It's taking 4 now, so that's a bit of an advancement too. Now, Blood Vile. He's the one, I think, before that got me, the other thing. Like, right now, inventory-wise... Nope, that's system. See, I still only have 6 Bloodstone Shards. Unless this guy on the other side of the room gives it to me, I think I can pretty much debunk my theory that you can farm a very specific area. Oh, screw you. I got my health back, though. Oh, a Bloodstone Shard. Hmm. Well, I'll be damned. Maybe that's just luck. What I'll do is I'll go back to the lantern real quick. Go in and out of the Hunter's Dream. Reset the enemies. And I'll go there again and see if I get another one. No, not that way. I remember. This way. I wonder if I have to go to Hunter's Dream, or if it'll reset the enemy. Yeah, I do. I wish you didn't have to in order to reset the enemies. I'm about to test this theory of mine out. Let's see what's happening. I was saying earlier that another podcast host there, Gabriel Galliani, he's been playing The Order 1886 starting today. Do not believe he and I quite see eye to eye on it. But that's precisely why I did not give this game a recommendation to anybody. I enjoyed it, and I knew that I enjoyed it, but it wasn't going to be for everyone. So, it's not going to be everyone's cup of tea. It's just not. I hate sitting on this couch in this living room right now, because we're going to be moving within the next month, and our house looks like a freaking disaster. And my son just had his birthday party, so we've got a bunch of new things hanging around, and it's quite the mess. I don't know. personally, how much longer I can live with all this mess around me, but gonna have to do it. Oh, you set me on fire? Fuck you, dude. Yeah, you give me that blood vial that I just had to waste. Because I was stupid and messed up. Just for that, I'm gonna come over here and kill your grandpappy, too. What do you think about them out? Unable to acquire every Quicksilver bullet due to inventory or storage mask. Okay, whatever. La 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 la. Knocked his ass down, didn't I? Still bit my ass anyway. That whip is fast, too. Is he biting my ass through the frickin' step, dude? Come fucking get it, dude. Got my health back fighting your ass, and now your friends are gonna get it. Just because you were a bitch. Nah, I lied, I was gonna kill him anyway, but you know. If it makes you feel any better. At least I was able to tame that beast. Without any issue. For this game, I'm primarily only using one of my two PS4 controllers. I think I'm going to replace one. I'll have to, after I move, I'll have to see if Sony will replace it for me. Oh shit. Oh shit. That dude messed me up. Me some blood vials. Just used a couple. Yeah, he gave me two. What was happening was, with the joystick on my other PS4 controller, my guy was sort of doing like this, a stutter step. I first started to notice it in the Order 1886, and I thought maybe it was a control thing, until I realized it wasn't, and I just got further confirmation just playing this game with the other controller that it's indeed the controller. Oh, blood vial. Didn't want to give me what I wanted. So I'm going to say I got lucky here. Before. Oh shit, I got stuck. Yes, I know. Cannot get all of them. Whatever. I just want one more Bloodstone Shard. Like, I'm almost, like, adamant about farming for it now. Because all I need is one, and then I can upgrade my weapon and feel that much more confident. Because really, in the Souls games, it's important to beef up your stats, yes, but it's also way more important to upgrade, you know, your armor and your weapons and everything. So having a plus 3 cane instead of a plus 2 would be great. Oh, did I forget you last time? Sorry I left you out. Have fun with your friends. And I'll be able to kill two birds with one stone here, because don't be like your worthless friend and give me a blood vial. Give me what I want. I mean, if you're gonna die, might as well be for something, right? Oh, you stubborn motherfucker. Head can take a fucking beating. They are, they're definitely, very liberal with, the amount of health you're able to take. I know you're playing the game on hard, I believe, which doesn't surprise me, because that's how you roll with pretty much anything. But, I played on the default, which is what I normally do for games, and I didn't have any problems with it except for one section right near the end of the game. Which isn't surprising, because that's how it usually is. That's the way it should be. It's near the end of the game, should be a bit more of a bitch. Oh shit. Wow. I'm epic failing right here. How about you guys? Are you gonna give me what I want? I should just throw a Molotov cocktail on your asses, but they're not so easy to find either. You gotta farm for those unless you wanna buy them, and who wants to do that? Oh, what the hell? That's what happens sometimes. Blood vial. I wonder if this guy down here is gonna help me out. This swing is fast, it's hard to, You gonna headbutt me? This is the first guy in this game that really took me a while to learn how to beat, because, I mean, I haven't... Oh, shit! I mean, he's not a walk in the park. He's fast, and he's tough. Of course, when you haven't had an opportunity to level up, blood vial. No, he's got the same for me as everyone else.
Well, maybe down this way. Oh, come on. That happens sometimes if you're not locked on. It just gets all janked up. And yes, you're hiding. He's got nothing for me. I'll whip it. But not for you. You get the cane treatment. Oh, and he set me on fire anyway. You bastard. Blood vial. Just what I wanted. Oh, I forgot about you. It was a good thing I was running, otherwise you would have got me. I did that earlier in this stream, too. I forgot about that guy. I always do. I'm gonna be in trouble in the late game, aren't I? Oh! Fucker with a gun. Where did you guys come from? Normally there's nobody up here. Except for that guy way down there by the gate. Sorry, I'm just typing away here. I don't know who's watching my stream. Gabe, if it's you. He basically just said one thing that's been bothering him in the order is that you cannot see Galahad's reflection in mirrors or surfaces. And no, that is an oversight. In that game, and it's something that people have actually actively complained about very early on, but it was drowned out by a lot of the other complaints that probably make a lot more of a difference when talking about this game. And that, of course, would be, God damn it. Coming down for you, buddy. Did I get one? No, I didn't. I can level up again. That's great, but that's not what I was looking for. Of course, now that I'm actually looking for one of those things to upgrade my weapons, since I'm so close, now the game doesn't want to give it to me. all is fair and in farming.
How about you? Don't be like your friends. Die for something. Damn it. Stubborn sons of bitches here today. Shit, don't die, please. Not like this. Oh, ow. I'm in trouble. Blood vial. Always the blood vials. Ooh. Where am I? I know where I am now, I think. Yep. Actually, I have no fucking clue where I am. I've never been here before. And this is a tad bit disconcerting, because I have a lot of blood echoes. And I don't know how to get back. Which was not my intent at all. I think, well, it's the sewers down there. It's got to be part of that. That's a shortcut, I guess. So is this sort of a cool trick, that cruel trick to have a ladder right here? Oh, thank God. I want to have the chance to level up before I die. since I've got it. And I got a Bloodstone Shard in the process, apparently. So there is that. I'm gonna have to thank someone for small favors. Get two birds stoned at once. Uh-huh. Did anybody watch the Walking Dead finale last night for this season? I'm not going to really go into any details. I'll just say that I enjoyed it. Very skeptical about a second Walking Dead series starting this summer, though. It's going to be overkill. Alright, first, let's talk to you.
Very well. Let the echoes let me.
Yeah. Skill, up you go.
Farewell.
Now the cane. Let's plus three this bitch. Awesome. Next it's Twin Bloodstone Shard, so I'll have to wait for that, but I can upgrade my Hunter Pistol. But I don't know, it seems to be working out okay for me thus far. We'll see. Anyway, I have to go to bed and make sure I'm up in time for work tomorrow, so. Oh, I might as well. I probably actually already repaired my cane. Yeah. How does someone die here? Oh, there was a dude in a wheelchair here before. And I think he probably tried to take him on and got his ass handed to him. Sucks to be him. And as always, I want to know if I can do anything over here. Probably not. There's also a gate on the other side, and I don't know when that can be opened either. But I'm always trying with every little thing that I do. But I don't think I've tried to open it since I beat the first boss. View Spectre. Well, something kicked his ass right here. Well, I can't see my guy's face at all. Anyway, that's it for me, everyone. You have a good night. This game is fun and I'm hooked. I'll be playing this for a long time to come, I think. Well, until I can afford to pick up Witcher 3 after it comes out, because that's now that Zelda U is not expected for this year, it's pretty much my most anticipated title for the year now. So, good night.